At about the same time that iRobot was in the planning stages, this company that I did the bulk of my work for started to run into financial troubles. And so while I was with them, I bid iRobot, did the breakdown and all of that. And then that company went out of business. So I still had my contacts with Fox, who I had done the bidding process with. So I simply carried on at that point and said, well, look, the digital part of that company is gone, the management is gone. But it was going to be me running that as a separate entity anyway, since the model shop was all freelance artists. None of us worked for that company. We simply occupied that space. I said, you're going to get the same people. It's still me running the show. Let's just continue on as we were. And Fox agreed. And so we continued on and did iRobot for them. And when we did iRobot, we had so many miniatures that we were doing for that because we were doing all in-camera practical miniature effects, which is really what we focus on trying to do. I think that's a really, like, that's sort of the strong suit of miniatures. You can build a really fabulous CG model of a car or a plane or a ship or whatever you need. But doing that practical interaction, if it needs to blow up or crash or come apart, is a lot more work in the CG world than it is for us simply to do it in camera. So that's where a lot of our work has ended up going, is doing that practical in-camera sort of work. And with iRobot, we did three versions of each of the models that we were destroying for that one sequence, the landing house sequence where Will Smith's running through the house and the robot is smashing it all down around him. So we had the robot, who was about 700 pounds and a 16-foot span, fingertip to fingertip, and he was about, I guess, about 8 feet tall. We built him sort of from the waist up so it would articulate this way with the arms and the head motion and all that. And then we had a second model that was just his foot and his upper leg for another shot. So we had one model of the robot and then three models of each section of the house that he was going to destroy. And so we were, again, because you're trying to get the most that you can out of each shot, we would set up for a shot and, smash a piece of the house. And then while we're waiting for feedback on the first shot, we would be setting up another model to do another shot and, moving all the cameras and the lights and setting up for a second shot. So we were trying to get two or three shots a day and then get feedback, from the first shot so we can go back and do our second take with our second piece of the model. And that was, logistically, that was a really tough show to do just because there were so many different pieces going on and the models were really very large. Everything was quarter scale for that, except for the final exterior shot of the house coming down that we did at sixth. But just a lot to build for that. There were, 9,000 terracotta roof tiles that we made, and everything having, of course, to be made from scratch. So a lot of R&D making the tiles, figuring out how they're going to break. Tens of thousands of individual bricks that we made for the exterior of the houses. Untold number of just brad nails that we used, pinning everything together, like scale. Quarter-inch brad nails pinning together plaster lath with the veneer wood over top of that. Just an awful lot of hands-on work building something like that to smash it all apart. And that one, was probably the toughest show I've done just because of the time frame and the number of models and the scheduling of it all and the coordinating of, this shot, then that shot, then back, and all of the different aspects to that sequence we were doing. That's when I decided that it was also time to move to a different location after we finished iRobot because there really wasn't anything going on in Toronto. It had become sort of like a ghetto for low budget movies of the week and romantic comedies and that kind of thing, and there wasn't any big production happening. There wasn't the kind of show that required our effects work happening. I hadn't done a local show in Toronto for probably 3 years prior to doing iRobot. I'd been doing shows everywhere else, but not in Toronto. So it just seemed like the right time. And so that's when I sort of came out from underneath the umbrella of this other visual effects company and went from being just a sole proprietorship miniature effects to a corporation and kind of went from there.